Hello again, sports fans. Are you ready? Are you ready for the weekly news? Because there's some good and some bad and some ugly. That should be the name of this, the good, the bad, the ugly. I posted a video that said that, but I think people take offense to that. So anyway, let's get started here. There was a couple fighting to keep a gate at their home in Hemingway. Hemingway, I'll use these names, but it's actually the village of Hemingway. But people that live here, we don't generally say that. You know, he lives in Caroline. I live in Hillsboro, but they're all the village of something. But anyway, he's trying to keep a gate at his home in Hemingway. They installed this gate at the entry of their home without ARC review or acceptance. They were found to be out of compliance. The couple is now fighting with ARC to keep the gate. I've seen pictures of this, and this is becoming an issue up there. I see both sides of a coin here. The gate's a gorgeous gate. What it is, it's a stucco home, and I'm sure you've seen pictures of the different stucco homes here, and you have the front entrance to the house. Well, that front entrance is usually 5 or 6 feet deep before you actually get to the front door. They put a gate across there, and they said they put it there because of some of the home burglaries that's happened in the area. I hear about a home burglary every once in a great while. I haven't heard about one for quite a while now. So I'm really not sure what home burglary they're referring to, or they're just trying to use that as an excuse to keep the gate. Who knows? But it is a good looking gate. I will say that. I mean, they probably spent a few $1,000s to get this thing done. I mean, most people here in the villages don't cheap out on stuff. They make it look really, really nice. If I was their neighbor, it wouldn't bother me none, one way or the other. But apparently somebody complained about the gate. ARC went up there and they saw the gate and they took a picture of it back probably. They went over and decided, well, it wasn't approved. Because it's viewable from the street, it wasn't approved. So they told them that the gate has to come down, and now they're going back to ARC, which they have that right to go back and file a, I don't know what you call it, where they relook at the case, maybe even get a petition from the neighbors saying that it's okay, all that kind of stuff. I don't know. Good luck to them. That's all I got to say. But if they got to take it down, here's how I see it. Very simple. They paid something like $400,000+ for this house, and they put up this gate that was thousands of dollars. You know what ARC is. These people have lived here before. They had another house they sold and bought this one. Why would you go to the expense of spending $400,000+ on a house and then spend another $1,000+ on a gate without going up and getting the approval first? I mean, it just doesn't make sense to me. I mean, just because a gate costs thousands of dollars doesn't automatically mean you can put it in. It just seems goofy to me. But anyway, they did what they did, and good luck to them. Residents in Summerhill are up in arms over a 16-year-old living full-time in the neighborhood. The mother of the child was recently arrested for a night of drinking at Sumter Landing. The child has been peeking in windows and running through the neighborhood. Mom is living with mom plus her kid. Summerhill is an older area, way up by Mulberry. And once again, we're talking about the older area. It's just a common denominator that mom's probably elderly. Mom probably needs a little help. And the daughter said, hey, mom, I'll come down and I'll help you out. I'll live with you. She brings her 16-year-old child to live in there full time. That's against the rules there. 30 days a year for anybody under the age of 19, and you got to go. Well, apparently, mom is a partier, and the kids running around the neighborhood. You can kind of get the picture of what's going on here. And then neighbors complained. They called and complained. And they came out and they checked it out and found out it was true. And so now they're telling the mom, the mother of the child, and then of course the resident of the home will get the notification too, because the resident of each home is responsible for anybody staying in that home, that that child's got to go. So I know that now mom is saying the child has a mental problem of some kind, and under the Disabilities Act, you know, she's going to push the issue but it's not going to work. So people are always pushing that line on the rules. And the ones that don't live here full time, basically, they don't really know the rules. So that's why the resident has to take responsibility. Mom should have told him he can't be here. So they're fighting that case. The new Lowe's on 466A is open. They finally got her open. I think it was yesterday or maybe today. I forget. Anyway, it's announced it's open. It's open for business. And I'm sure from what I know of down here, Lowe's is going to do a good business right there. They've got an online thing there too, where you can get on the their website and you can buy anything you want from that store. You pay for it, of course, with a credit card. And they have a drive-up window or something. You just drive up and I guess you print out a receipt on the computer. I don't know how it works. And you pick your stuff up. You don't even have to go in a store. It sounds kind of cool to me. Okay, and matter of fact, this next question, a guy sent me an email 2 days ago about this, so listen up. This is going to apply to you, and you're going to get your answer. Language has been loosened to allow villagers to install gasoline generators in the wake of a hurricane. Now they can install them next to the air conditioner and within 2 feet of the property line. That's a good thing. They've had language in there all this time. Apparently you couldn't install them, or at least the gasoline ones, I guess. I'm not sure why. It maybe has something to do with the air pollution around here. Maybe it's got something to do with, I don't know, maybe a fire hazard. I'm not sure. But apparently the language has been loosened now where you can now install them. They got to be next to your air conditioner, and they can only be within 2 feet of the property line. So if you're going to buy property and you're going to install one of them, check everything out and make sure you can install it, you know, legally. Because like this other problem, you may install it, your neighbor gets along, he may never say a thing, but then he sells his house, somebody else moves in, they find out this language, they find out you're within 1 foot of that property line, not 2 foot. He makes a report, they're gonna be knocking on your door telling you you got to move it. You're gonna be saying, hey, it's been there for 5 years, nobody's complained, I ain't got nothing to do with it. You're within 1 foot of the line and the language says two, and you're going to have to move it. So just know what you need to know. The Rialto Theater, that's the oldest theater here, it's in Spanish Springs, is celebrating 20 years. Boy, don't seem like 20 years. I remember when that theater first opened up, when I was still working then. Wow. Anyway, there's a big picture on the front page of the newspaper, and there was a cute couple on there. Older guy, and I think it was his wife. They've been working at that movie theater ever since it opened. They've been there for 20 years. So if he retired, I was doing the math. If he retired, let's say at 60 or 62, you can do the math. He's in his 80s, she's in his 80s. They're both, they had big smiles on their face, and they both looked like they were enjoying life. So good luck to them. A convicted child pornographer moves into the village of Virginia Trace. A 75-year-old child pornographer. That is disgusting. 75-year-old from West Virginia, and he spent 4 years in a federal prison. So I'm not sure exactly what kind of pornography he did. I don't know if he sold it, bought it, transported it, I don't know. But to spend 4 years in a federal prison tells me that either he's been caught more than once or he's done something really serious. But anyway, this seems like this is an ongoing thing here. You see it at least once or twice a year in the paper. Because it's public knowledge, they have to report it. And they usually put it in the paper. They have a picture of the guy or girl, whoever it is, and it's public knowledge. I don't know, it's just because this is a retirement community, I guess. Children are not allowed to be here on a full-time basis, so I guess that's why they're here. But I have always been an advocate, and I don't know if anybody at the village's management department watches my videos, but if you are, let me just say this. Any of these child pornographers, because this is public knowledge, that move into the villages, I think it's your responsibility to see to it that their pictures are posted at all of the family pool areas in a glass enclosed case so nobody can take them down. And with a little note saying, If you see any of these people at this pool, call this number and report it, because they're not allowed to be around children at all, and you're not doing it. So I think you're falling short. Village of Santo Domingo man convicted of his seventh, count them, seventh DUI after violating his probation. I don't remember the whole story, but I'm sure he got something out of this. Another year of probation. God. Chula Vista Rec Center is going to be closed for quarterly maintenance. This is normal. They close these rec centers down every so often. They close the pools down every so often. They do their maintenance on them. That's what keeps them looking the way they look. It's normal for that to be happening. Residents in CDD 2, thanks for the center line. They've been arguing about that for the longest time up there on the golf cart trail. If you've been down here, most golf cart trails is an asphalt lane. On the curves, they may put a little reflectors or something, you know, or whatever, but basically it's just a wide slab of asphalt, and that's what it is. They're not lit up very well at night at all, so you knew people coming down. Unless you know exactly where you're going, I'd say be home really in your golf cart before dark, because the trails look so much different at night. You'll get lost. So just be careful, that's all. But they've been arguing about a center line up there on their golf cart trail. And I think it's, and I almost swear to this, but I think it's along El Camino Real Boulevard there. There's a lot of cars up and down that road. There's a golf cart trail right next to it. And at nighttime, and I've been on that trail at night, especially after a rain, all the headlights from the cars coming down that road, and it's not very well lit at all. And if you've got a little bit of a vision problem, and certain people have their headlights on their golf cart, they're not set right, everybody wants to add these lights to their golf carts. Why, you know, it's nothing to see a golf cart sometimes coming at you with these bright ass LED lights on them, or they've added two or three fog lights under the bumper to see. Well, they can see, but they're blinding everybody else. And so I think that's what that center line is all about, to kind of at least help people know where the center of the darn thing is, because there is golf cart wrecks that happen around here. Villages is threatening to close the Mulberry Dog Park. Residents there aren't living up to the original agreement, not cleaning up, and stealing all the free poop bags. Ain't that hilarious? I can tell you the story, a little story about that. All the dog parks we have down here, I'll say from 466 and south, and actually there's even one north of course, but I'll say 466 and south, those dog parks were part of the planned community, so they're not going anywhere. The dog park in Mulberry was never planned. It was a hunk of land they had, who knows what it was set aside for, I don't know. It was a hunk of land that the villages had, and they were complaining about a dog park up there, and through the channels, they got it done. But there was an agreement that the villages had, because our amenity fees don't take care of that up there, because it's not part of the community, the planned community. They said, if we make this a dog park, and I don't know if they put fence around it, or maybe the fence was already there, I don't know, but they said the residents will have to take care of it. They'll have to clean up after their animals, and so on and so forth. And I do think that the villages is supplying, or at least the CDD2 board is supplying, the free poop bags. There's a little stand they got up there inside, so that if you bring your doggy up there and I forgot my pickup bags, it happens. There's a whole bunch of free ones up there. You just pull one out, and they just want you to clean up. That's all. Just clean up. And apparently somebody, or maybe more than one, I don't know, they're stealing all the free poop bags that some other, the residents are paying for. And apparently there's been an argument about they're just not even cleaning up after their dog. And I do know that that happens here and there. But flip side of that coin, there is a resident up there that wrote a note in to the editor of the paper, and they published the note saying that they didn't know where they got that information, because he goes to that dog park on a regular basis and he has never seen that problem. He said, yes. He said, there has been some poop bags stolen. He has addressed a couple of those people about it. And he says, as far as he knows, that stopped. And as far as he says, picking up after their dogs, he said, almost everybody picks up after their dogs up there. He said, once in a while it may happen and somebody never noticed their, because their dogs run. And somebody may have never noticed that their dog took a dump back there somewhere. He said, but other residents is kind enough that when they're walking around with their animal, if they see it, they'll go ahead and pick it up. He says, so he hasn't seen that problem, and he don't know where they got that information. We'll see how that turns out. Village 2, oh yeah, that was announced a couple days ago. I seen it in the paper. That'll be interesting. We're going to be an experimental community here. I don't know exactly when this starts. I'll let you know, of a driverless taxi cab. I don't know how many there's going to be. There might be one for each square. I don't know. But a driverless taxi cab. That's almost like the future is now, isn't it? And everybody's talking about it, wondering how it's going to work in roundabouts, all this and that. And one guy made a statement. I had to laugh. I had to laugh. He said, I thought we already had driverless cars in the roundabouts. It is funny because there's a lot of people to come here, man. They are totally lost in a roundabout. They have no idea what they're supposed to do. And it's amazing to just sit back and just watch. But yeah, we'll see how that works out. A woman was airlifted Tuesday at 11 a.m. to the village's regional hospital after being struck by a golf cart. It was up by 466A and Morris Boulevard. I can only assume, hold on. I can only assume what happened there. It was a walker, and she was walking down the golf cart trail, and I don't know exactly what happened there, but she got struck by a golf cart. I've seen a lot of things on both sides. I've seen walkers on a golf cart trail. There'll be two, three, four walkers walking in a group, and that's fine. But they don't use their common sense. They'll walk right down the middle of the golf cart trail and they refuse to move over in a single file line off to the edge, or they just won't move. I don't know where they get this idea. And I've seen a few arguments about it. That could be the problem here. And the lady that went around them, there was another cart coming this way. She tried to squeeze her way through the cart and the people walking, and then she nipped one of them, I don't know. But whatever happened, it's a darn shame that, the poor lady, who knows how old she is in a hospital, says she was bleeding from the head, I'm sorry, and her respiratory was shallow. Her breathing was shallow, so they airlifted her. If she'd be, anybody being airlifted, it's probably serious. So I'll just say God bless the lady in the hospital, and I hope she recovers, and maybe there'll be more to this story later on. Son of legendary Penn State coach to speak at Village's alumni chapter. His name's Jay Paterno. I'm not a big sports fan, but I do remember his father and the big whoop-de-doo about all that. I don't know how that's going to turn out, but he's selling a book. Every time somebody comes to the Village's for anything, it seems like they're always selling something. Anytime Fox News comes down here, somebody on Fox News comes back a month or two later because they're selling a book. And this guy's no different. He's selling a book, and he's going to book signing. I'm not sure what the book's about. I'm assuming his dad. But that's going to be a real controversial thing probably when he gets down here. We'll see how that turns out. A postal drop box was pried open at Bellevue's post office. Well, that's a federal offense. I don't know who done that, but if you get caught, goodbye. Two carts crashed at the tunnel coming from Pinellas under Buena Vista, the tunnel. I know where they're talking about. If you guys know where Evans Prairie is, if you go past Evans Prairie and you're heading, let's say, toward Lake Sumter, actually that's east, but everybody calls it north. But actually, that's due east. If you're heading east toward Lake Sumter, Once you go past Evans Prairie, you're going to go down an incline, and then right there to your left is a tunnel that takes you over and around to the Pinellas Boulevard. Right there. That is kind of a tricky area, and I've seen a lot of stuff there because I travel that road on my golf cart quite a bit to go play golf. Matter of fact, I'm going to go up that road today. I got 11:40 tee time, and I'll be going that way. Golf carts come out of that tunnel, and they either make a quick look and just take off, or they don't even slow down. They just come out of that tunnel. There's a stop sign right there, and they just take off. They just don't pay no attention. And I'm going to guess that's what's happened, because from what I read, they said the guy coming out of the tunnel failed to yield right away, crashing into the cart, knocking the guy and his wife both. The cart overturned, knocking him and his wife both out of the cart, and I believe they both went to the hospital. So, and the guy in the other cart didn't get hurt. That'd be my guess. He didn't stop at that stop sign. And in a lot of cases on the golf cart paths, they don't put up a red stop sign like you see on the road. I mean, maybe they need to start doing that. I don't know. Because really, these golf cart paths isn't that hard, you know. It's just common sense. But they'll write on the ground when you come to a section. There'll be a big, long line like it's a pedestrian crosswalk. And in great big white letters, it'll say stop. Apparently people don't think that means stop. I don't know, but I mean, those things happen around here. So be very careful, especially during snowbird season when you're riding around your golf cart. It's not good. I want to end this. This has nothing to do with the news really, but I don't know about you folks, but I'm getting sick and tired of Hollywood and these stupid movies they keep coming out with. I went and seen two of them. I'm just telling you, save your money. Just don't even go, because they're totally boring, totally stupid. The movies are way too long. Let me just tell you, they're dumb. I know. Skip, tell us what you really think. Blade Runner is one, and Downsizing with Matt Damon is the other. And I like Matt Damon as an actor. And I find myself a lot of times going to movies only because who the actor is, not really what the subject matter is. And Matt Damon's a good actor. And that movie of Downsizing was totally boring, stupid. It was just... save your money. And Blade Runner was even worse. I mean, 2 hours and like 40 minutes long. By the time you buy your tickets and your popcorn, 40, 50 bucks, and you're going and seeing crap? I mean, it's going to get to the point, I'm just simply just not going to go to the movies at all anymore, because I'm just getting tired of spending money to watch crap. So anyway, just saying. Till then, till next Friday. I guess I'll see you guys later. I got a question and answer coming up that I'm going to publish. Ladies asked me a lot of questions. A couple other guys asked me a lot of questions about things, golf carts, golf cart rentals, insurance on golf carts, all these kinds of things. I don't know if I got the exact answer for you, but I've got some answers. So I guess until then, I'll see you guys on the other side.